There are over 7 billion people in the world who all need energy to live, to heat their homes, power their machines, and to drive their cars. With the supply of fossil fuels in decline, how will we keep the lights on? The world is using fossil fuels to provide energy. But fossil fuels are no longer the only, best, or even cheapest way to meet our energy needs. Mankind's oldest energy source may be the answer to this problem. Our cavemen ancestors knew the value of bioenergy every time they kept warm by a wood fire. So let's look at bioenergy. Energy from the sun is stored in organic matter such as leaves, wood, and straw. Take a plant. A plant absorbs sunlight and converts the sunlight into chemical energy through photosynthesis. The energy stored inside the plant can be released by heating it in a bioenergy process. Today, this means that we can use all sorts of ways to help keep the lights on. And we don't have to grow special plants instead of food. We can use food, agriculture, and manufacturing residues. We can reduce the number of lorry loads going to landfills too. Bioenergy has global impact. Some of the poorest countries are some of the most energy hungry, but every single country is rich in sources of waste. But with wind, solar, and tidal energy available, why is bioenergy important? Let's look at Birmingham. The sun doesn't always shine, the wind doesn't always blow, and it has no coastline for tidal energy. As the UK's second largest city, it is home to over a million people and thousands of businesses, all creating waste every single day. Our research at the European Bioenergy Research Institute is showing that something useful can be done with waste sources, such as food waste, sewage, harvest residues, and waste from manufacturing. It doesn't need to be burned, so without any pollution, it can be transformed into clean, renewable energy. Bioenergy. So to keep the lights on, bioenergy has a vital part to play. To learn more, visit www.ebri.org.uk and www.bioenergy-nw.eu.